Hello, freaks and geeks, and welcome to another ASRC Oval Series race. And well, tonight we're at Homestead, Miami, and this track is going to be really, really tough on everyone because it's another track with a loose setup with a rear end, loose rear end. So it's going to be really tough out there. Tonight, and hopefully I turned down my mic enough, because I've I turned it down a little bit too much there. Okay, yeah, hopefully that does a little bit better. whoops. Alright. So yeah. Let's go ahead and qualify and get this over with. I don't know why I'm really nervous about this. I placed fifth in practice, but I can't keep up that lap time pace over and over again, because I'll just spin out. So whenever it comes to the actual race, I'm gonna have to, you know, take it easy and tone down the pace, especially if I want to save my tires, because going on a all-out run, I could definitely tell that my tires looking at the result of my tires wear after that run, I could tell that I could not be running lap times like that. But since this is qualifying, we are going to go all out. That wasn't a great first lap because I hit the wall. But first lap is always slower. We actually got a really good run off of there. The liftoff.
10th position.
Yeah, see how much better of a run we got. That could have been a lot better. Shit. Well, there goes our run. I don't know how much time I was up. I was probably up a good second.
You're now 4.0.
Or so. Not a good second, but a good. The thing on the screen always kind of makes it more deceiving, but I was definitely really up on the time. Yeah, see, it's not clear on me if we're needing to go below that or just below the apron.
What's your speed?
See, how much time do we have left? About a minute and a half. Yeah, as you come out, that doesn't exactly make any sense.
That's the end of the session. P11.
I just realized I wasn't, something happened in the, for the mic, whenever I was trying to adjust the volume, and for some reason it went all the way down. I don't know if it was at the beginning of the record, well actually, no, whenever I tried to adjust it. Why did it do that? I don't know how long I was just not talking there. Well, technical difficulties there, sorry about that. Oh... let's just leave it. My god, this thing is so finicky. Because I don't want to have it so quiet, but also I don't want to have it so loud.
67 laps.
Okay, I'm just going to have to leave it there. Yeah, I'm just going to have to leave it right there. Okay.
Follow car number 78 in the outside column.
Sorry about that, guys.
Okay, good.
You guys can stay back there, it's fine.
I wonder what's going on with Jason.
Good luck, everybody.
Oh.
Yep, good luck.
I think
there's
I know
a bunch
what.
Of guys that didn't call it up just yet.
Ah, shit. Okay, I'm just gonna have to leave that there for now.
Selling jumper team bring my bed after the race. Come see me.
Holy shit, that was... What type of start is that?
Get on our side. Get outside.
Sorry if I'm not going to be talking so much, but I'm going to have to concentrate as hard as I can.
Oh, no, sorry. Get high.
P6, that lap was at 34.8.
I'm using up some tires here, but I want to make some ground. me, and plus we're gonna have to pit anyways.
That's gonna be fastest lap.
And so I'm probably gonna pit. Oh, it's actually not 100 laps. Okay, so we hit 100 miles before 100 laps. That actually makes sense on this track. But yeah, we're probably gonna have to pit. I mean, I know on this thing, I know you can't see it on here, but on this thing it says we can finish. Actually, no, it just that sucks.
We have to pin it behind us now.
That sucks for Jason.
Shortest lap in this session. Okay, Corey, pit window open.
Okay, so I can pretty much pit any time now. I have a splash of
fuel. 62.
Alright. So, fifth place is right in front of me.
The gap is now 1.0 seconds. That lap time was 34.7.
I wonder if they know that the low line's actually going to eat up their tires a lot, at least in that corner. Actually, I wonder if that's the case. Ah, I got distracted. Thinking thoughts. Yeah, once you lose your rhythm, it's kind of hard to get it back, but as long as you don't mess up on the next corner, it should be good for the next two corners. Like, it's fairly easy to get your rhythm back, but you have to make sure you don't bend it. He kicked up the pace, though. Be a part of the plan. Kind of late there. I had to get on the brakes. Yeah, I'm probably using up too much tire.
That lap was at 35.2.
Yeah, I can definitely feel it. I need one. And the fucking walls is like blue around here. I was trying to come off of it without getting loose into there.
Monarch is reading you in. The gap's now 0.58.
I'm gonna start looking after my tires now. I say as I brake late as possible, or let off late as possible.
Sorry, Brad.
Okay.
Well, it looks like enough people had issues and stuff that a top 10 is for sure. Jesus. See, that's why we don't go low. We should definitely think about pitting around lap 35, I say. Although, with me saying that, I wonder how other people are gonna deal with their tires, and if the yellow's gonna come out. I mean, people are more spread out.
The lap time was 35.3.
People are more spread out. Yeah, I need to stop letting off like I'm like on new tires, because that's not the case. Yeah, man. I wonder if it's actually more worth it to go late into that corner. Yeah, see, I let off late again, and that loses me time. But I'm having a feeling if I let off about the same.
gap to Murphy, clear on the outside. Time was 36.2.
Ah! Wow, the car suddenly just got super tight whenever it didn't go like that. This is really starting to piss me off now.
Time was at 35.6.
And now I need to turn my wheel more and more.
E9.
I just don't know if it's my tire temperature or whatnot. I'm running the fastest lines and everything. This is so fucking frustrating.
That last lap was at 35.9.
Okay, I let off too late there, but...
was at 35.9. The gap to Monarch ahead is increasing. It's now 2.4.
God, this is so frustrating. I let off too late there again.
Was at 36.1. time was 35.7.
I'm begging for someone to crash.
The gap to Monarch ahead is now 2.3. Time was at 35.8. Gap to Monarch ahead is now 2.2 seconds.
Just to clarify,
that's halfway. We think about 27 laps remaining on this time.
Do we pit, whenever we pit, do we go below the apron? Like the white line apron, or do we go in that little road strip going off at 3 and 4?
Pitting off at 4, forward.
Okay, I guess I'm gonna go below the apron then.
P8, that lap was at 36.6. Speed limit is 50 miles per hour. Okay, we'll fill you to the end. Box in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Box now.
Got to put myself in neutral again, but whatever.
All clear on pit exit.
Got lost where I was there for a second.
The car in front has just posted at 34.2. Thank you. Okay, Corey, we're in the lucky dog position right now. Guano is now in the lead. Now 7.5.
Sorry I'm not talking all that much. I'm just concentrating really, really hard.
Come on, Corey. We need to get by. Murphy, put us in the lucky dog position.
Knowing my luck, we're gonna get a yellow right about now. Before everyone's done pitting. Why am I actually going down low like this? So, okay, Ryan is also going down low, so maybe, I don't really know about tire wear, and going up high, like, seems like it's actually, I feel like I'm using less tires going down here. And it really does seem like that. Granted, definitely not gonna get past Brian, but... Or, Brian's gonna get past me, but you can get what I mean. Rain. Like, don't get me wrong, he's about 4 tenths quicker than me, 4 or 5.
That was at 55.5.
So I'm not gonna fight him that much.
Still there. Clear on the inside.
8th place.
Plus he's a lap ahead of me. And all that other malarkey.
increasing. It's now 35 Celsius. You've just done 35.5. Okay, Corey, you're reeling Murphy in. The gap is 3.7 seconds.
The pace compared to old tires is actually quite astounding. I'm gonna be able to get Murphy. You know what, I thought I could get a top five, but with how tire wear was, it's not gonna happen. I turned way too much. I wanted to go down low. I think the car is actually getting to that point where it's actually more fat. It's faster to go up high instead of 1 and 2.
Sounds clear.
Oh, that was actually for position. Shit. Okay, so I am the lucky dog right now.
The car ahead is Monarch.
Alright, so I feel like I'm in a good position right now. Even if the yellow comes out.
Is now 1.0.
Even if a yellow does come out, I would get the lucky dog. Everyone else will, that's in front of me, will come in for fresh tires. I won't have a chance against them, but at the same time, I will probably have a good chance of keeping this P7. Yeah, you know, I have no more tires.
Last lap was at 35.3. Track temperature's increasing. It's now 37 Celsius.
Yeah, it's about 10 to go. Actually, it's going to be 10 to go next time for me.
Lap time was at 35.1.
So why am I turning the wheel so much?
P7. Was 35.1.
Sorry I'm not talking so much. I just realized there was a big gap of silence. I'm just focusing so hard and trying to push as hard as I can, because I just now realized there's actually a good chance of me possibly
sixth place,
getting like either, well, sixth place or like a top five or something. Definitely won't get Johnny.
Yeah, catch up here.
Because he just came out on fresh tires. All of a sudden, this just turned around for us. How many laps to go for? With three, okay, with three this time by.
chase your bike.
Oh, it looks like we're going to be able to get a top five here.
Mini is getting closer. The gap is now 5.9 seconds. Two to go.
Yes, come on.
E5, white flag, last lap. That was at 36.0.
Oh! Yes! Oh my goodness!
P5, that's the finish. Well done.
That is such a relief. P5! And that was actually a legitimate finish. That wasn't I mean, I guess there was some luck, but... I feel like that was actually legitimate that time.
Eric, I'm impressed.
I'm out of gas. Yeah.
Look out for the pit speed limit. Yeah, box in 1160 feet. Box in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Box now.
Ah.
Congratulations on your win, Brian.
Thank you, Jason. Yeah, good run, Derek. Good run as well to Eric. Nice attempt there to train and fuel save. I'm really surprised.
What is going on here?
Pleasantly surprised you got to the end there. That's some good fuel saving.
Okay, there we go. What was our tires there at the end? About 50%. Well, either way, we got fifth place. I actually got my goal, top five. Excuse me. Yeah, I thought we would actually have a caution, but it seems like we didn't have any cautions. Sorry about that. I was just looking in Discord for a second. Yeah, I wasn't really clear on what they mean by off of four. As you come off of four. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, okay. I see what. Okay, I wasn't getting that. As you come off of four. That. Okay, yeah, see that? I'm just not conducive to pitting like that, in all honesty. So. Well, fuck me. I'm probably gonna get a penalty for that. More than likely, I don't know. And that's gonna get my P5 in the. That's gonna ruin my P5. Fuck. just the terminology off of four, like that, like okay. I don't know. Just to me, it would make a lot more sense if someone said, "As you come off of four, not just off of four." Like, what is that supposed to mean? I don't know. I'm just. Then again, I'm just a dumb, simple-minded fucking idiot. Anyways, I'm still not good at this outro stuff. I haven't been doing, like, incidents reviews and stuff after the race. And to be fair, I don't think there will be, there shouldn't, or there's not that much to really do. Because there wasn't no yellows and stuff like that, so. Yeah, I guess that would be it for this week's race. If you like the video, please give it a like. And if you want to see more of this type of racing content, please hit the subscribe button. And also, head on over to the link down below if you want to see catch this this race live in a hosted race setting. Over at IceyOtter's channel. Yeah, IceyOtter's channel. Blah. Oh my goodness, I'm getting tongue twisted on my words. And you would think I wouldn't be because I didn't talk all that much during the race. But yeah. Go check out the links in the description for anything that you pretty much have a question about. My rig, what equipment I use or software I use, all that will be down in the description below. And until then, I'll see you in the next video.